Good morning, students. This is Dr. Dilbaj from Laharpur Khalsa College of Engineering, teaching discrete mathematics. So today we are going to discuss very important application of graph theory, which is traveling salesman's problem. So what is that? What kind of a problem it has? If you will go through the detail of traveling salesman problem, it is like that. If a salesman travels from city to city or some place to another place with his allotment territory in such a manner that he has to cover all the cities or places once and only once, means whenever he want to visit, the condition is he want to visit all the cities but only once in during his tour and come back to his base city. So this is the target, and the travel salesman problem can be served as an assignment problem with the following restrictions. So these things are very important. The number one condition is the salesman starts his journey from his base city and come back to his base city. That is the one thing. And after visiting all the city once and only once during the tour allotment to him, means he has to start from the base city and come back to base city. That is number one. And during that, he has to visit all the cities once and only once. This is the first condition. The second condition, the objective of salesman is to cover minimum distance. Okay, means he has to choose the cities in such a way that he has to cover minimum distance. That is another important condition. The third one is the salesman cannot travel from a city to the same city. Okay, and although the cost of traveling city to same city is zero, but this assignment is prohibited. So cost of traveling from city to city we will taken as a infinite. This symbol we will use for the assignment. Correct, means wherever you have to come, go from A city to A city, then you will take infinite value. Okay, now there is a complete procedure. We have approximately you can say 6 to 7 steps to proceed with the questions based on the travel salesman problem. And we have a construction of cost effective matrix, reduction of cost effective matrix. So better to, because when I will explain these steps in general, then you will not understand. Correct? So I will try to make you people understand these steps by giving the examples. So here we have an example. So this is the example. Try to understand the example first, and then I will make you people clear that what is the meaning of these steps. So let's try to understand the problem. What kind of problem will be given? A salesman wants to visit city 1, 2, 3, 4. He does not want to visit any city twice before completing the tour. That is the condition of the tour. All the city, wishes to return to his home city. That is another thing. Of going from one city to another city. Okay, the rupees given. Find the least cost route. This is the main thing, means salesman has to choose the path in such a way that means the cost should be minimum. So if you will go to the first step is the cost effective matrix. You have to construct it. So what is the important thing in the cost effective matrix? It must be a scale matrix of order n into n. So sometime if it is not a scale matrix, then you have to complete it by adding the dummy row or a column. If one column is missing, then you will add the dummy column. If one row is less, means it is not n by n. If you have a 2 by 3 matrix, then you have to convert into 3 by 3 matrix. Means you have to add one row. And if it is 3 into 2 matrix, then you have to add one column. So main thing is the cost effective matrix may be of scale matrix. So this is already given. Like In this example, it is given that it is square matrix because it is of order 4 into 4. But if sometime it is not given, like from 1 to 1, 2 to 2, 2 to this, but let us suppose this column is not given, then you will take, you will add it and you will take 0, 0, 0 and all these things. I hope you understand what is the meaning of n into n matrix. So it is, in this example, it is already given that it is 4 into 4, means this is the cost effective matrix. Correct? So the next step toward the procedure, find the reduced cost effective matrix. There are two kind of a reduced cost effective matrix. One is the row reduction, another is the column reduction. What is the meaning of row reduction? See, this is the cost effective matrix. In the row reduction step, what you will do, you will find the minimum value. So before that, you know that wherever zero value is there, already we have discussed in the first three steps, wherever zero value is there, then you will put the infinite symbol over there, because see, we have put infinite wherever. Zero is here, you have put infinite. 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 Correct? The another important thing is, now you will do the cost effective, row reduction. Row reduction means, except this infinity, you will find the minimum value from a row, and you will subtract that value from each of the element. Means the in from this row, the minimum value is 3. So you will subtract 3 from each of the element of this row. So 3 minus 3, you will get 0 here. See, and 8 minus 3, you will get 5, and 5 minus 3, you will get 2. Now see, what is the minimum value out of this except infinity? It is 3. Correct? So 4 minus 3, you will get 1. Okay? So 14 minus 3, you will get 11. And 3 minus 3, you will get 0. Correct? Very much clear. Now, what is the next step? The next step is 4, 5, 2. Out of these, this row, you have a minimum is 2. So you will subtract 2 from each of the element of this row. 4 minus 2, you will get 2, and 5 minus 2, you will get 3, and 2 minus 2, you will get 0. Correct? And in the same way, minimum value from this row is 7. So 7 minus 7, you will get 0, and here you will get 0, and 8 minus 7, you will get 1, and 13 minus 7, you will get 6. So this is the row reduction matrix. So after that, what you will do, you will find the column reduction. So what is the column reduction? So whatever the row reduction matrix you got, out of that you will get the minimum value from the row. Okay, and you will subtract, except infinity, you will subtract that value from each element of the row. So here you have a 0, here you have a 0 is minimum, so 0 minus 0 is 0, and 1 minus 0 is 1, 2 minus 0 is 2. So out of this column, minimum is 0, except infinity. So 0 minus 0, 3 minus 0, 1 minus 0, same, no change. Out of this, you have minimum is 5. So 5 minus 0, 0, 11 minus 5, sorry, 5 minus 5 is 0, 11 minus 5 is 6. 6 minus 5 is 1. So out of this, minimum is 0. So 2 minus 0, 2, 0 minus 0, 0, 0 minus 0, 0. So I hope you understand. So this is the row reduction, this is the column reduction. Correct? So next is the step number 3. In the step number 3, you have to make assignment in the reduced cost matrix, coefficient matrix. So what is that? See. So you have to, so what you have done in the two steps means you have done the row reduction and the column reduction. Up to here, you, I think it is clear to everyone. Now the next is, you have to select, because what you have seen here, from up to this steps, you will get many zero in the rows and columns. Then the third step is to, you will select zero element in such a way that only one selection in row and a column. Okay, how? Means you will start from the row. So first element is zero, you will mark as a scale, sorry, as a scale box over it. So other zero in that row must be crossed. Okay, now you will take this row. So this is the first zero you have. Other rows, other zero, so same thing is here. All the zero in the that row, row of this one should be crossed, and all the zero in the column must be crossed. So no zero in the column, so you need not to cross it. Correct? So what is the here? So when you will see this column, this row, the first zero is this. So you will mark it. I have marked it. So no other zero is here. No, zero in the column, you will cross it. Okay, now you will move to next one. Okay, so what you will get here? So it is, you have to cross it. You already crossed, so need not to worry about it. You have already crossed. Now see this one. So this is the first, means the final, means what you have done here. See this. So one mistake they have done. Here is the mistake. So after that, I think it is very much clear in the step number 3. Means you have to choose 0, you will mark the 0. So you will mark all the other 0 in that row or that column crossed. So now you will take the same thing you will repeat in the second row. You will mark the 0 and other 0 in the row and column should be marked, crossed. And the same way in the other. So this is the first solution. So we want to see whether this solution is optimal. Optimal means whether it satisfies all the condition or not. So what are the condition? So what is the solution here? Means you see the marked zero. Here you have a marked zero. So what first solution is, from this is the marked zero, means salesman will move from one city to two city. Correct? This is the first. After that, you have this is the mark. From second to 4, means from second to 4, this is the second one, and this is the fourth, from 4 to 1, correct? But what you have seen, it is not covered the city C. Now this is the problem. So therefore, it is not a optimal solution. This is not a final solution, because we have to visit each city exactly once. So what is the next? Now we will shall bring the element 1 into the solution, because now we have to see the next minimum value. So next minimum value is 1. So how you will choose it? So let me erase this one so you can understand this one. So the next minimum value is, next minimum value is 1. Okay, you can see the next minimum value is 1. So what you will do? You make the unity arrangement in the cell, because see, the first one is here, correct? So what you will do, wherever one is there, the choice of the marking, if one is more than as compared to zero, means so you don't have any one in this row, so you will not mark. So you have one here, you will mark first one here. Okay, and you will not take, you will not mark any other value, other means zero will be crossed and no zero will be crossed, because this row and this column and row has been covered. So what is the next? You don't have any one here, correct? You will mark one here, and you don't have any even one here, so you can mark zero. You can mark zero, but priority of one is more. Okay, so Here you have already crossed it, so thing is there and you will make it cross. They have not crossed, you have to make it cross. Now see, what is the final solution now? So what is the final solution? What is the final solution? Only they have done mistake, this you have to cross it. So they have not crossed. This is the main thing. Now see, what is the solution? So from 1 to 3, this is the first one. And from here, from 3 to, okay, from 3 to 4, correct, 3 to 4, then 4 to 2, 4 to 2, and 2 to 1, correct. So I think they have covered all the elements, but if you want to see the cost, okay, because the cost, so you know that, see the place, this place, this place, this place, and this place. So from 2 to 1, so what is the cost? You have to see the initial. Cost is 4, correct? So you will take 4, starting cost was 4, okay? So cost is 4, from 2 to 1, the cost is 4. And from 1 to 3, see, what is the cost given in the question? The cost was 8, okay? And you have taken 8 here, okay? So next, from 3 to 4 and from 4 to 2. 3 to 4, so 3 to 4, it is 2, 3 to 4, and from 4 to 2 means 8. So you will add 2 and 8. This is the final cost of the path. So you have 8 and 2. When you will add, you have a rupees 12, 22. Means the cost of the traveling is the 22. Correct? So one solution you got. But problem is, if they have not asked that you have to take minimum cost, then you got the answer. You need not to do anything further. But here you have to choose the minimum cost, then you must find other path also. Okay, so how you will find the other path? So what is the next? So in the previous step, we have assigned unity in the 2-1 column. Means we have started from 2-1 column, assigned the unity in the 2-1 column. But here, next, instead of from 2-1 column, we are going to make the unity array assignment in 4-2 column. Means here is the unity also. So if you will assign the unity here, correct? So what happened? What happened here? So what happened? You will get the same result because already you have done the same thing. Same matrix you will get. So and the same matrix you will get the 22 only. Correct? Same matrix you will get. Same. No change. You have to cross it. No change. But in the another thing means now we are going to assign the unity in 4-3 column. When you will assign the, this will be crossed. Okay, and this will be crossed because column and row and column must be crossed. So here there is only one zero is here. You can mark it. And unity preference is best. First you will mark it and you have a put zero. So what is here? So now you have from 1 to 2, correct? From 2 to 1, you can put in the last, okay? And from 3 to 4, and here is from 4 to 3, okay? So 1 to 3, here some mistake is there, so better, here they have done the mistake, means from 1 to 2, from 2 to 1, means you have completed it. Okay, so here is the problem. It is not a feasible solution. So you need not to add on the cost. So this way you can find the answer. You have only two options are feasible solution, 22 and 22. So the final answer, you can take any one of the these two. I hope you understand. So in the similar way, you have other examples. Two more examples are there. You can go through these two examples. If you will find any doubt, you can give me the observation. I will try to clarify your doubts. but these are very interesting examples. No questions, unsolved questions, only three questions. Okay, this is one very important application. I am not sure whether it will be the part of final examination, but it is part of the syllabus, so that's I have discussed with you people. Thank you very much, and we will come with the next lecture. That was the last topic of your graph theory and your discrete mathematics, that is tree, and it is very, very useful topic of the graph theory. Thank you very much.